woke him up. Frightened by his mother's bedtime story, he searched for his sister's comfort. But she was nowhere to be found. There once was a girl who snuck out of her bedroom window at night, even though her mother had told her not to. She went into the forest, and at first it welcomed her with warmth and a promise of adventures. But soon, the forest seemed to grow colder and darker. The girl was afraid, and she wanted to go home. But Bramble crawled around her arms and legs, and she could not get away. And the girl was never seen again. That is what happens when you do not listen to your mother. Especially you, Lilimor, their mother had said before kissing them goodnight. The darkness outside scared him. But not being with his sister scared him even more. The nearby forest was a familiar place during the day. But at night, it was a different story. There was no trace of Lilimor, and Ulle wished he could ask the pine cones if they had seen her. But if the pinecones knew about her fate, they kept it to themselves. light in the dark. A symbol of hope. A spark of courage. What do you have there? Lilimur asked. It glimmers beautifully. What a strange rock. Light as a feather. She investigated closely. Let us play, little brother, Lilimur bubbled. See if you can knock down this pine cone. Together, they tumbled down deeper and deeper through the old ruin. Follow me, little brother. I will protect you, Lilimur said. She was never scared like him. Ulle wished he could be a little more like his sister. Lilimur loved adventures, and Ulle loved Lilimur. Gnomes are peculiar and playful creatures. They live peacefully in daylight and keep in their houses at night. Visitors that don't want to eat them were unheard of until this day.
Thank you.
They were both curious in different ways, while Lillemor quickly ran along. Ulle could get completely enthralled. And suddenly, Ulle was alone again. The river was strong, and Ulle was weak. He did not stand a chance. But soon the sound of the river faded. Ulle was happy to have firm ground under his feet again. Frog King made sure that his new friend did not drown. But without his sister, he felt like the loneliest child in the world. He just wanted to find Lillemor and go home. To do that, he had to find where the big troll had taken her. Ola wanted to cry. A couple of hours ago, he had been in his warm bed. Now, he had almost died several times. His sister was gone, and he was soaked in smelly sewer water.
Oh!
Ulla felt bad for the ill-treated giant. Lammas might be big, but he had a warm stone heart. All he longed for was a friend, but his face scared away most. Even so, it seemed like he had found one. Ulle was comforted by the morning sun. He had survived the night, but but just barely. At least he had found the stone again. And it felt like it was his sister's way of telling him he was on the right path.
Dumalkas ljuva sång. Thank you.
In his past life, Nekkin was a simple man that loved playing his violin. But the village did not appreciate his talent. People would frequently bully him. And the only soul that did not was a girl that Nekkin fell in love with. One day, the bullying and beatings became so severe that Nekkin's anger finally overtook him. He marched into the village, playing forbidden melodies that made everyone dance until their flesh and bone got worn down. They eventually died, leaving behind shuffling corpses, still trying to dance to Nekkin's melodies. His love was not spared death either. Devastated, Nekkin left the town and lived by the lake, drowning in his sorrow, where he still lures people with his deadly music.
Come on.